sense of security. And while we're doing that, put in a real evacuation plan, a plan of action that will protect our kids. And, you know, I'm not so much in the idea that's been thrown around in the past 24 hours about teachers carrying the guns. Teachers went to school and went into education to teach our kids. They did not go to school to take on what they have taken on. And you know as well as I do, Madam President, that teachers have taken on not only the education and teaching our kids, they're the social worker. They make sure the kid eats. They bring supplies to the school. They do social work. They're doing everything. Now we want them to carry a gun. I'm not so sure I want that to happen. What I want to happen is for us to really take a look at the securities to make sure that what happened in Florida never happens again, and at least in this community, we have taken it on our avenues and the positions of putting cameras in places. And anybody that wants to debate me on this issue from anywhere else, that we have everything in place, you're wrong, and I'll take you for the ride, and we'll go around the city and we'll check out exactly what is protected and what is not protected. I was up at the high school. We addressed the situation at Parker Street School because they couldn't see out. We realized that those windows have tarnished up. They can't even see anything coming, if it's coming, and when it's coming. The whole thrust behind us tonight is to put something in place. And you know what? We all have a place in this, even the students and the faculty. And that's why I place above the panic button, and also you hear it, you see it, you report it. Together we can make our school safe. Stop posturing. And kids, let's stop following it. You hear something, say something. Because it's a matter of life and death. And we don't want what happened in Florida that has broken our hearts to happen here. And don't tell me it can't happen here because it's happened in our surrounding towns. You all remember Dartmouth, right? You all remember Mrs. Day a long time ago when you were Christian school? Maybe we forgot Dartmouth some time ago when she was gunned down. I don't forget anything. And I haven't forgotten our students, and I haven't forgotten the faculty, and neither has the city council as far as addressing the issue. And we've addressed it over and over. And I just want to say one more thing, and I'll sit down. The other day, after we addressed this the other night, and how it came out in the media, and when I talked to Phil Palaiologos in the morning, I was very disturbed with the man going on the air later on in the afternoon or in the morning. And he didn't take phone calls. He wanted to talk about the school committee, and this was him putting in place measures to increase the security in the school. You're doing damage control. And you know, as a leader of the city of New Bedford, you have to stand up and you have to talk to the people. You've got to have an open arm. You've got to wrap yourself around people. After what happened on February 14th, people wanted to talk to you. But no, you chose not to take any calls, and you're fluffing stuff, and you're talking about the windmills, and you're talking about this, and right now we need you to talk about security in our schools and taking care of our kids. And matter of fact, take the phone calls, because that's what leaders do, just as many of us in this room take the phone calls and take the hits even when we don't want them. I'm going to sit down, maybe somebody else has something to say.